สวัสดีครับ Hello to everyone. My name is Kasit Piromya. I would like to return to the screen to talk about Thai politics. I've been away for quite a few weeks having difficulty with my technical team. But from now on, I think I could come back to talk to you on a more regular basis. Today, I just want to give a short comment on the state of Thai politics. What's going on, what will be going on, and so on from my point of view. I think at this point in time, and I think for the next 6 months, there will be more, I think, intensities and robust political activities in Thailand, as every political parties and politicians will be juggling for position to be ready for the upcoming national elections. I think it could be expected to be, I think, by the middle of next year. So we have about 6-7 months left for political parties and politicians to prepare themselves. But in order to prepare themselves, I think the juggling for position, the alliances, the realliances, you know, the amalgamation of some parties and so on, inducing politicians to jump across from one party to the other and so on. And each of the political parties will be tabling the names of the prime minister candidates and so on. So it's going to be a lot of fun in that sense to observe what is going on and what will be going on. But my only concern is that all of this, it's about politicians and political parties, but not much about the improvement and of the democratization process of Thailand, in the sense that people will be left on the side looking into the political activities of politicians and political parties, but not much for them. So in that sense, I think it doesn't bode well for the future of the democracy of Thailand, because we are still living with a constitution that is half authoritarian, half democratic, or in other words, still allowing for the armed forces or military intervention in politics through the representatives of the military. Current serving military and police officers still have seats in the upper house or in the Senate. So in that sense, I think it is quite in contravention to the ideals of democracy that bureaucrats, whether in the civilian or in the military clothes, should not be involved in politics. But the current Thai constitution allow bureaucrats, military officers, to be directly involved in the political life and activities of Thailand. So for Thailand to become a full-fledged democracy, there must be drastic amendments of the current constitution, or even to draft a new constitution that will honor the universal values of democracy and human rights and freedom of expression, and a separation of, I think, the role between the bureaucrats and the political life and so on, and to make political parties more answerable to the members and to the public, and not answerable to the financier of that political parties or to the leadership of the political parties. And political parties as a whole must not be a sort of a self-vested interest entities. They should be the vehicle that stands in between the political institution and the public at large in general. That should be the bridge between the people and those who hold powers. And at the same time, they should also be the vehicle of the democratization process of Thailand. So hopefully that if there were to be drastic amendments of the constitution or to have a new constitution, there will be rules that will ensure that political parties are public institutions, democratic one, serving the people for the benefit of the country. And although the politicians and political parties, especially the members of parliaments at the moment, have not done much about the constitutional reform or amendments. The only amendments that they did make was about the composition of the House of Representatives, you know, a combination of a party list and constituency list. And I think the voting system, instead of one vote per one person, that covers both the political parties and the candidates of the from the constituents. From the new elections next year, there will be each person can do two votes, one for the party list or for the party, the other one for the constituents candidate. So the major amendments of the current constitution so far is by the political party and for the benefit of the political parties. It has nothing to do with the public at large. So in that sense, I think political parties and politicians, and especially members of parliaments, have so far failed to really reform, transform, or revolutionize the current constitution to make it really democratic, similar to the constitution of neighboring countries like Indonesia, Taiwan, South Korea, Japan, and further away, Australia and New Zealand. And as long as we have a constitution that is half democratic, half authoritarian, democracy in Thailand would not move that far. So it is incumbent on the Thai public at large to keep on fighting for a more democratic Thailand. That will be, I think, the principles and the spirit would be laid down in a new constitution. For myself, I am not no longer involved in the formal politics, but I have been working with many civil society organizations and advocates of democracies and human rights. I think we could say that we, the people, I think we are working together to come out with a draft new constitution that will be democratic, both in spirits and in letters. And I will keep you abreast of this undertaking by the civil society and by the Democrats and Liberals of Thailand. So thank you very much for today. Sawasdee krab.